Hey guys, it's Kayla and welcome back to my channel. If it's your first time, hi, hello, how are you? Thank you for clicking on this video and watching. We are back for another episode of The Waiting Season. As you can see, I have a mic, so we're gonna test this out, see how this works. I do have a white noise going on in the background, so I am sorry if you hear that. I'm definitely working on sound and filming and all of that. I am back home, so it's really hard to find good places to film. But nonetheless, I am so excited to be here today to share with you all some more things that God has been working on me. That saying always sounds wrong when I say it. But God has been teaching me in this season of my waiting season. So if you like my face, if you like my content, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And let's go ahead and get started with the video. Okay, so I just want to say again, thank you, thank you, thank you. If you clicked on this video, it's been so fun to film. Like, I just look forward to filming these videos. So if you have different topics, if you have feedback for me, if you have any type of information to help me make these videos better, even if you say, Kayla, you just need to find a completely different place to film, whatever it is, like I said, I love filming these videos, so I would appreciate your feedback. That's a perfect segue because we're going to be talking about how to stop being so easily offended. And I have not even nailed this down, but we're gonna get into it. So I'm gonna have practice today with your feedback. So let's get into it. So the spirit of offense or being easily offended is something that I started to see the outward shift in me. And that's really when I started being intentional about working on it. And this is how I realized I was easily offended. So a little bit of background, I'm a very sensitive person. Somebody could look at me the wrong way and I'm gonna cry. So I've always been very sensitive. I've always been, you know, easily offended. Another thing about me is that I'm a perfectionist, and my perfectionism is so bad that I also want other people to be perfect. And if other people are perfect, that offends me. Because why do you act like that? Why are you behaving that way? Why don't you do the things that I do? Why don't you talk like that? Why don't you understand that it's not okay to say certain things? So that's a little bit of background. But what's been happening recently is our favorite app in the world, TikTok. I don't know if you all have noticed the shift in TikTok, but the past couple of months, TikTok has been so political, rage bait, giving opinions on Black women, how to be this, how to be that, seeing people teach kids things that are just highly inappropriate. And when all of these things come out, as we know, people make TikTok videos. They share their opinions. They share their opinions about people. They share their opinions about the situation. It's just always an opinion on something. And so sometimes I would make videos about different situations and controversies that come up. And it's mostly about Christianity when I'm making a video. But I started falling into that pattern. And then I would start having I would start defending myself like in my room. So if I watched a TikTok and that TikTok offended me, I would go on a 5-minute rant defending myself. Nobody is here. Nobody can hear me. Nobody can hear what I'm saying. But I'm so flustered and frustrated. My feelings are hurt. I'm starting to become self-conscious and just mean-hearted and bitter and all of these things over a TikTok video, for one. And then over a rant that no one can hear. No one can hear me sharing my opinion, my voice, and everything. And even if you share your opinion, everybody is still not going to agree with you. And I would get offended over the fact that people weren't agreeing with me. At some point, it's you. It's you. Yes, there are things in this world that should be straight line, no room for interpretation, but there's not. There is room for interpretation even within Christianity. Someone is always going to find a way to, people are always going to feel indifferently about certain subjects. We can all agree that child maltreatment is wrong, but what you consider child maltreatment and what I consider child maltreatment might be two different things. And I may fully believe that you are absolutely crazy for even considering that, but that's your opinion. So, y'all, it was bad. It really was. I became judgmental, bitter, passive aggressive, which was crazy because I cannot stand passive aggressiveness. I would rather you just come straight to me, say it how it is, and move on. But I became passive aggressive, making shady jokes, but laughing it off. And it caused conviction because I could outwardly see how it could make people not want to talk to me. It could make people think I'm judgmental, think I'm snarky, and I have such rude remarks. And I just didn't like the responses and reactions I was having to people making statements or making comments or giving feedback or giving criticism. It didn't change the fact that those things still hurt, but my response, it just wasn't a response that I was proud of. And so I really had to sit down and ask the Lord, God, help me with my response. Help me in, even if I get worked up about things, I don't want to respond that way. I don't want to show people that they've offended me. And I don't want to act in that same way. And everybody, even though you're offended, everybody doesn't mean ill will towards you. You know, it may be an offensive thing, but that doesn't mean that deep down in their heart, they're trying to talk about you or talk bad about you or intentionally hurt you. And so the Lord has been working on, the Lord has been teaching me and guiding me and really deconstructing my thoughts, my opinions, my judgments, in so many ways. And I haven't passed the test. He's given me so many tests in this month alone with this specific thing. And other things too, but with this specific thing. And I have failed every test, y'all. I'm not gonna lie. I have failed every test, but I'm gonna tell you what I've learned from failing these tests and from the Lord speaking to me. I'm gonna give a little story time. So, like I said, the Lord was telling me that I need to stop being so, well, I cried out to the Lord that I wanted to stop being so easily offended. I wanted to stop being hurt by what others do. And so one day I watched this YouTube video, and I'm going to link all of the videos that I watched down below if you want to go look at them and watch them. But I was watching this YouTube video, and it was a pastor preaching about offense, and the sermon was so good. And in the sermon, he started talking about casting the first stone. And I just broke down because I always hold the stone. And I feel right. I feel so right. I have so much pride in holding the stone that it breaks my heart sometimes when the Lord tells me that I have to put my stone down, because I feel so justified in holding this stone. I want justice. I want righteousness. I want all of these things. And the Lord says, put the stone down. And that hurts. And I just broke down because I was like, I have to put the stone down. There are things that I do that I wouldn't even qualify to be able to hold a stone. And yet I pick it up. I always look at what other people do, and I never take the moment in the middle of the offense to start remembering what I do. Because I do self-reflection. I know my faults, sometimes to a really bad degree. I'll pick on myself and be hard on myself. But in those moments where I'm quick to judge others and throw the stone at others, I don't take a moment to reflect on myself or to realize that just because it isn't my issue, just because it isn't something I struggle with, doesn't mean that that person isn't in the same place I am with my struggles. So that really broke me down. Then later that day, I was on the way to work and a coworker had offended me. I can't even remember what the offense, which goes to tell you that we get so worked up sometimes in the moment about things we literally will not remember later on down the line. But I don't even remember what I was offended about. But I went to my office and my church had given me this feeling wheel. And attached to each feeling, it was a breakdown of other feelings associated with the main feeling. And then from the breakdown of those other feelings, there was a Bible verse attached. So I went to anger. Or being angry. That was my start feeling. And then I went to annoyed because I was angry. I was annoyed in that moment. And the scripture that was there was Proverbs 19:11. And y'all, listen to what this scripture says. Proverbs 19:11 says, "A person's wisdom yields patience. It is to one's glory to overlook an offense." And y'all, I just was like, Lord, I hear you. Like, Lord, I hear you. Like, Lord, this is, I gotta let it go. A person's wisdom yields patience. Wisdom, being wise about the choices we make, being wise about what to say, when to say it, how to say it, what to walk away from and what to stay. Patience. Lord, something I struggle with so much, having patience. And it is to one's glory. Glory. We think that by saying things in that moment and being snarky and having rebuttal and getting our lick back and getting our get back, standing on business, telling people that they can't check us and cross us and talk to anyway, we think that we become winners in that moment. But what God says is glory. Not for our own good, but for the glory of the kingdom. Glory in God's eyes comes from overlooking the offense. So I had to let it go. And so then that was that situation. Then at church, my pastor began a series on offense and unforgiveness. She preached a sermon about Joseph and how Joseph had so many opportunities to be angry, bitter, mad, to get his lick back. But every time Joseph focused on his purpose, he focused on trusting God. He focused on what his gift was and using his gift for the glory of the kingdom. And every time people crossed Joseph, he didn't harbor anger. He didn't harbor bitterness. He didn't go around checking his surroundings, making sure he can't be around nobody or, you know, being to himself or isolated. No, he still walked in his purpose. He still did what he was called to do. The very thing, the very gift he had that caused other people to be offended by him or caused him to remain in certain situations, that very gift he continued to use for the glory of the kingdom. And when his brothers came back, He was shady. He was shady now. If you read the Bible, he was shady. He was like, "I'm Joseph. Yeah, the one y'all threw away. It's me." But he embraced them. He loved on them. He told them, "You don't have to be afraid. I still love you the same. I appreciate you for what you did because it brought me to this place." And forgiveness is something you can only do through God. In our own flesh, our flesh will tell us every time not to forgive. But forgiveness is something only God can change your heart to be able to let go of the things that people have done for you. Because there are some deep hurts in this world. There are some unforgivable things in this world. But only God can show you how to forgive the unforgivable. Only God can show you how to let go and move forward. So what do we do? How do we stop being easily offended? The first thing is to slow down. I had to learn to slow down. And I'm still learning how to slow down. You have to slow down. When you hear something, intercept it, process it. And even if you feel like it's coming out before I even say it, whatever method you have to do, close your mouth and say, give me 1 second. Let me think about my answer and I'll get back to you. Let me think about my response and I'll get back to you. Learning how to slow down. Slow down. Think about what happened. Think about the situation. Think about what was said. And don't be so quick to respond. Next thing is remembering it's not our place to humble people. It's not our place to correct people. It's just not. And so many times our responses and reactions to offenses, we feel like, oh, I have to teach this person a lesson. I have to teach this person that was wrong what they said. But it's not our place. It's not our place to do that. Next is praying for a quiet tongue. You literally have to pray for God to help you be quiet. Silence. What do they say? Real gangsters move in silence. 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 God, help me to hush. Because first of all, what I want to say isn't going to be productive. And second of all, it's not even worth my breath. So pray for a quiet tongue. Slow to speak. Slow to anger. And quickly to listen. Next, you have to learn the power of forgiveness. There is so much power in forgiveness. So much power in forgiveness. So I really recommend books, sermons, teachings, mentorship on how to forgive, therapy. Y'all know I'm always mentioning therapy on how to forgive, learning how to forgive, because the power in being invincible to the things that people do to us, imagine what we would be like. I always think of, like, I'm not good with superheroes, but I'm gonna just say Superman. If Superman was getting shot up and he was just walking through the bullets just flying off of him left and right, the power, I'm sure that as he's walking to whoever he's about to get, he would feel like the man. He would feel like the man because you're not even bothering me. You're not even bothering me. I'm unbothered. Next, do the healing work. Again, if that's therapy, if that's prayer, consecration, fasting, if that's getting prayed over, whatever it is, do the healing work. We have to heal from these wounds, y'all. A lot of us are walking around with open wounds, bleeding and making a mess, spreading infections and viruses, all of that. We have to do the healing work. It is time to heal from things that have happened to you in the past. And it is time to stop allowing things that are happening to you in this present moment to create a wound. Heal from what happened in the past. And in the present, don't give it the opportunity to create a wound. Don't give it the opportunity to cause an infection. We have to heal. We have to heal. Because becoming easily offended, when you're quick to be offended, y'all, that is because you have so much junk in your heart that your defense mechanism is easily triggered. You're in fight or flight mode. And that is why every little thing ticks you off. Every little thing makes you want to jump, because there's so much junk in the heart that you have to be on defense mode constantly. You're constantly in defense mode. We got to heal. We got to heal, y'all. Lastly, learning that God is bigger than what people say. God is bigger than what people say. He's bigger than it. He's bigger than it. Your purpose, your plan, your calling, becoming who you are, coming out of your waiting season, the consecration in your waiting season is more important. Being pleasing to God, being who God called you to be, is so much bigger than the things that people say to us, or the things that people do to us, or the things that we hear people say about other people, but we relate to. Because that was my issue. Like I said, with TikTok, nobody had said anything about me, but I'm a Black woman, so it still applies to me. You got to get over that. You got to let that go. Now, don't get me wrong. I'm an advocate. I love to advocate for people. I love to advocate for communities. But you can advocate with good intentions. You can advocate for people without trying to be defensive and without harboring on to the slander, the hate, and all of these things that people get. That was my lesson for this month. How to stop being easily offended. Because, like I said, I was becoming judgmental, bitter, angry, passive aggressive, and I can't stand passive aggressiveness, rude, yelling. And I was like, the old me would have never done this. I don't want to be seen this way. I don't want to be like this. I want to be able to just brush it off my shoulders, not let people walk over me, but just to brush it off my shoulders. We got to do the work, y'all. We got to do the healing work. So I feel led to pray in this episode, so y'all just bear with me, and I just hope that God speaks through me and that this video touches the right person who it's supposed to touch. So let's pray. God, thank you for this day. Thank you for this opportunity to stand before your throne. Lord God, right now I ask that you give us wisdom. Wisdom to know when to speak. Wisdom to know when not to speak. Wisdom to know when to act. And wisdom to know when to sit still and wait on you. God, right now I ask that you grant us favor, Lord. Despite what's going on around us, despite the things that are happening to us, despite the hurt that we feel, Lord, we have favor. And so we don't have to act out. We don't have to defend ourselves. We don't have to be in a constant state of fight or flight, because you've already granted us favor, Lord. I pray that whoever is watching this video, whoever is listening to this prayer, who is struggling with unforgiveness and who is struggling with offenses, Lord, that you speak to them, that you touch their situation and teach them, that you clean their heart up, and that you guard their mind, Lord, to become a new person, to become a person that reflects your love, your kindness, your peace, and your grace. Thank you for this opportunity to speak to your people. Amen. Alright guys, so if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Comment what was your favorite part of the video. Comment if you struggle with being easily offended or struggle with unforgiveness. Let's talk and chat about it in the comments below. I love you guys, and I'll talk to you guys next time. Bye!